Hello all and welcome back to the lecture series of Goods and Services Tax 309 paper code. Now we'll take up audits again. In the previous session we talked about the general audit and the turnover based audit. Now we'll take up the special audits today. So in the previous session we talked about the general audit, which needs to be conducted by the chartered accountants the commissioner or additional commissioner. Then it was the turnover based audit, which needs to be conducted by the chartered accountants or cost accountant that is appointed by the taxpayer itself. Now we will come to the special audit, section 66. So let us discuss it in detail. Any officer not below the rank of assistant commissioner may demand an audit and section 66 of the GST Act. And this he can do if he believes during the time of scrutiny that the value of supply is not accurately declared or input tax credit availed by the registered taxpayer exceeds the credit actually due. So as you can see here, for the special audit it has been clearly mentioned that any person not below the rank of assistant commissioner or any person above this rank may demand an audit under section 66 of the CGST Act. So the rank has to be considered here, that not less than assistant commissioner rank can demand for special audit. Now this he can do if he believes during the time of scrutiny. During the time of scrutiny means during inspection or during search, if there has been certain discrepancy which is being found out. This inspection or search we have already discussed in the previous sessions, so you know what is inspection and search here. So under inspection or search, if any discrepancy has been found out in reference to the value of supply which has not been accurately declared, or in reference to the input tax credit availed by the registered taxpayer exceeds the credit actually due. If there is any discrepancy in input tax credit that has been availed, and the input tax credit that the taxpayer has in his account, then in that case, the assistant commissioner or above rank person can demand for the special audit under section 66. Now the assessing authority takes the approval of the commissioner to undertake such an audit, because without this approval or authority, no audit can be conducted. Hence, on such approval, the assessing authority guides the registered person to get the books audited by the nominated chartered accountant or cost accountant as per the provisions of section 66. So now you can compare the turnover based audit and this special audit. Like in turnover based audit, it was clearly mentioned that the chartered accountant or the cost accountant is the only person who is going for that audit. But in that case, the appointment of chartered accountant or cost accountant is being done by the taxpayer, the registered taxpayer. But here in this case, the one who is going for the audit is the chartered accountant or cost accountant only. But in this case, this needs to be done by the authority. The authority will give the permission that, or you can say, appoint the chartered accountant or cost accountant for the special audit purpose. The circumstances for special audit arises after commencement and before completion of scrutiny, inquiry, investigation or any other proceedings under the Act. So this is what we were talking about, that if previously any discrepancy has been found out, or there was inspection, investigation going on, or inquiry was going on, a scrutiny of certain records was going on, and it has been found that there is certain discrepancy under the information that has been disclosed and the actual transactions, then in that case the special audit can be conducted. And further, the commissioner issues such a direction informed GST 83 to the registered person. So notice will be issued. If you remember, for the previous audits it was form GST ADT 01 and 02. Now it is 03 for the special audit. Thus, the chartered accountant or the cost accountant selected by the officer then submits the report of audit duly signed and certified by him to the assistant commissioner. After the conduction, this needs to be submitted. The final report needs to be submitted to the authorized person who has given the permission for the audit. This is done within a period of 90 days. So time limit is 90 days, and this period can be extended by another 90 days if there is a delay. So this needs to be extended maximum to the further extension of 90 days. So this work initially needs to be completed within 90 days, but if further extension is required, further it can be extended to the 90 days period. The registered person will be given the opportunity to be heard in respect of any material gathered and is proposed to be used in any proceedings against him. So any, whatever is the records that is being found for the discrepancy, the person who is the guilty is given due chance to say his side, that why such discrepancy is there, to listen, and it becomes the responsibility of the authorized person to listen to his words, like what explanation he wants to give for the discrepancies that is being found in the records, and is proposed to be used in any proceedings against him. And these can be these records can be used as a proof for the proceedings also. Next, it says, where the special audit conducted results in detection of tax not paid or shortly paid or erroneously refunded, then or input tax credit wrongly availed or utilized, the proper officer may initiate action against section 73 or 74. So as we have discussed in the previous slide also, that if such special audit results into the detection of certain short payment of taxes or discrepancy under the input tax credit availed and utilized, or you can say any sort of tax payment was missing. So any such discrepancy will be dealt under section 73 or 74, which says whether it is a fraud or it is not a fraud. That we will be taking up in the next sessions. Thank you all for today. Let's take up the new topic in the next session. Thank you.